Jammu and Kashmir is ill at ease when it comes to security, both along the line of control over past few weeks and also in hinterland. There have been some incidents. I am joined by Mr. SM Sahai, IGP Kashmir. Ms. Sahai, welcome to NewsX to start with. Not very well, the situation both along the line of control and hinterland, as when we have seen militants striking here as well.
Well, yes, the border has been rather tense, more in the Jammu sector than in here. But of course, I'm not in a position to really answer for what has happened there, because that is more in the domain of the army. As far as the hinterland is concerned, I think if you look at the overall situation, it has definitely been improving. And I think 2012 has been acknowledged as the best year so far from all points of view, whether it was street violence, whether it was from the point of view of terrorism. From all aspects, it's been very good. But notwithstanding that, there is a sense of fear with regard to a certain section of the elected representatives. And as the democratic process becomes more and more broad-based, these threats will tend to increase. We are very concerned about it. And in the past, we have tried to take measures which would try to stop this problem altogether. But as long as terrorists exist, the threat will continue to be there. And in view of the recent killings in Sopor area, we have put into place measures which we hope will help to minimize such actions. As far as every other thing is concerned, yes, all parameters of violence are down, and we do expect that the year 2013 would be definitely an improvement to the last year.
As you mentioned that, you know, there have been certain measures have been put in place. Can you just elaborate on that a bit more? Because the security of these elected representatives has been a sticky point. It's been promised many a times, but then we still have incidents like what happened in Sopor happening.
Well, you see, the whole thing features around providing security on two facets. One is giving individual security. Now, individual security is provided on the basis of individual threat. And that we will provide to anybody, regardless of who the person is. It can be a common citizen also, if the person is under a specific threat from terrorism. Now is the issue of generally improving the environment. That we have been trying to do. That is the overall purpose as well. I mean, the whole idea is that we fight the terrorism and improve the security environment. But alongside that, we will definitely, in view of the presence of elected representatives, try to define the vulnerable areas so that our entire focus for area security becomes more precise. And if there are vulnerable areas, then we can address them.